Welcome. Today we shall go through the article on return on equity, and that is ROE versus DuPont ROE on the Wall Street Mojo platform. So let's understand what is the concept of ROE. That is the return on equity, is a measurement of profitability. Profitability of a project or an entity of a particular period, and ratio of profitability over equity, that is the amount invested by the owners and the shareholders. Next is, what is the utility of an ROE? ROE shows the measure and the nature of success of the business during the period. It measures the corporation's or the entity's profitability by revealing how much profit a company generates within the money shareholders have invested. Basically, it indicates the amount of profit available for shareholders after all deductions. This is a ratio of profit over the amount invested by shareholders. And let's look into the calculations of ROE. The ROE calculations are generally on the two types. The general method that of calculation of ROE is, it's the net income generated by the entity or the organization divided by the average shareholder's equity. So what is about the average shareholder's equity? It is arrived at averaging the opening and the closing shareholder's equity. We shall understand the details in next tab once we go through the numbers. And then there is a detailed method which is known as DuPont method of ROE. And the DuPont method of ROE generally is a little expansive manner. The calculations are generally in an expansive manner. It's like the net income over net sales multiplied by net sales divided by the total assets, and total assets divided by the total equity. So it's basically a profit margin multiplied by total asset turnover and multiplied by equity multiplier. So this is basically a combination of three different ratios, and this method is used to find out the exact reason for the change of ROE from one period to another. Now let's understand the general calculation of return on equity. First of all, this side we'll see the small demonstrative profit and loss statement, and we'll construct a small balance sheet and go on to calculate the return on equity. So here let's do some profit and loss statement, try to construct a profit and loss statement. And balance sheet. So let's do it for 2 years, that is year one, and here it is year two. And so let me take it over there in balance sheet as well. So balance sheet, here there is a small mistake, let me correct this one. And so here is year one, and now let me do other heads in the profit and loss and balance sheet. So let me start with sales and other income. So then we have the total income, and now next is the expenses related head. So here we have, say, suppose the material for to run an organization or do some production, and then labor, and then so we have the other expenses and total expenses over here. Now let's put it the gross profit. That is, and so we have the profit after tax and dividend or for preferred shares, and we arrive at the net income of the period. So now let's populate the numbers over here. For example, sales, let's have a number 865. Let's put it as 865, and then next year it goes on to increase at 950, and then over here let's put at 90 and 100, and total it comes to this plus the, so this is over here, that is the total income. So we have the total expenses, we have populated the expenses over here, so let's put it at one line below to match. Okay, so we have the total income as 955 for year one and total expenses as 715. Now let's populate the other figures, that is gross profit over here. So this, So let's do it over here. And so now we have the profit before tax as 180 and 183. And let's have the tax figure. See, it is, this is over here. And let's go on to calculate the profit after tax. So we have calculated the profit after tax and dividend on preferred shares. And so put in a figure, like a constant figure for both the years, and we have arrived at net income as say 155 and 157 for respectively year 1 and year 2. Now let's quickly construct the balance sheet, and then we can arrive at the return on equity figure to understand how it is calculated. So we have populated like the heads as fixed assets, current assets. Then we have the total assets, that is fixed assets by current assets, and the liabilities one. And then we have the total liability and net assets, which C is equal to total asset minus total liabilities, which is the net assets. Now we will populate the figures over here. So we have populated the figure, fixed assets say 1250 and it moving on to 1325 for second year, and then the total assets coming as, and we have the current assets as 450 and 510. So these are the figures, and we arrive at the, with the long-term liability and current liability figures over here, we arrive at the net assets as 1275 and 136. So the next is the preference capital. So we put in a figure of preference capital, and then we move on to have the shareholders' equity divided into reserves and capital. So let's now populate the figures for this preference capital, shareholders' equity, reserves and equity. So we arrive at the shareholders' equity as 900 and 990 divided into reserves, say reserves and equity capital. Equity capital is constant for both the years. Reserves is increasing on year on year to 50 and 340. So let's have a shareholders' capital and a previous year, as we'll put in a figure over here to arrive at the average equity capital required for calculation on return on equity. Next, we have now the profit and loss and the balance sheet over here. Let's highlight both the cases. And over here, and now let's go on to calculate the return on equity, which we are understanding in today. So now we have the return on equity over here. Let's calculate the return on equity. The formula is A equal to net income divided by average formula. This formula close. So we have 17.9, and now let's convert it into percentage terms. So we have 18% over here, and if we click and drag it over here, so we have the next year. So this is 18% and 17% over here. Let's highlight over there to understand this. So in the border over here. So now we have calculated the return on equity in the normal way, that is the net income divided by the shareholder equity average capital for each of the period, year 1 and year 2. So now we'll look into the return on equity for the Dupont method, so which is a detailed method of understanding the return on equity. So here let's have the different ratios. Ratio over here, say we have the profit margin, then we have total asset turnover ratio, and then equity multiplier. So here, and finally the ROE, return on equity. So ROE, basically it's let it put it over here so that it's clear. And so let's have it for, say, firm A. All these ratios for firm A and firm B. Basically, this is an illustration whereby we'll see the same ROE for both the firms, but there are variations in the underlying different ratios, which shows how the business is running in both the cases. So here, let's have the profit and profit margin, that is the total profit divided by the sales. So here, say, let's have it as 40% over here, and say we have 20% over here, and then the total asset turnover, let it be 0.3 over here, and say 5 over here, so which shows high asset turnover. Equity multiplier, that is the number of times the capital is getting multiplied for running the business, and over here 5, and say 0.06 over here. So ROE is basically, as we have understood in the beginning, so let's do it over here, centralize. And so ROE, as we have understood, it's basically in the DuPont method, it is the multiplication of all the above three ratios. So let's do it over here. So 0.4, that is 40% is 0.4 into, so 0.3, that is the total asset turnover, and then finally the, so this is 6, and over here it's, say 20% is 20 divided by 100, which comes to as 0.2, and now multiplied by the total asset turnover, which is 5, and so multiplied by equity multiplier, which is 0.6. So basically in both the cases we are seeing the same return on equity, but the breakup of the different ratios, which is consisting of the ROE, has different numbers. So if we understand what it is, so let's try to understand how this implies about the business. So for firm A and firm B, let's try to segregate and understand the figures. So the firm A, the profit margin is high. The profit margin is high. Basically, these are the observations over here. So we can see the profit margin is high and the financial leverage is also quite good. That is at 5, that is the equity multiplier, the financial leverage. And whereas the asset turnover is low, that is the firm, which is at 0.3, spot 3, and the firm is not able to utilize the assets better. Now moving on to firm B, how the figures, understand the breakup of the figures for the firm. So the firm B, the profit margin is lower, which is at 20%, whereas the financial leverage is very poor, that is at spot 6, whereas the total asset turnover, that is the number of times the assets are getting turnover during the period to run the business, is 5, which is on the higher side. This for high asset turnover, the firm has done well and arrived at the high return on equity figure. So in both the cases, whether in different ways, the numbers are different, but the end result, that is the ROE, is same in both the cases. So the conclusion over here in this study is, in the DuPont method of return on equity, is the DuPont highlights, this calculation highlights underlying figures resulting in a particular ROE. So even if the ROE is same, it will highlight the different ways, underlying ratios about how the business is running and how the firm is performing during a particular period.